another anatomy and physiology discussion video, because for today we are going to discuss about your human blood. Welcome back to my channel. If you're new here, my name is Neil Gavin. I'm a registered nurse and I do have a degree in medical surgical nursing. I create my nursing educational videos to help nursing students and nursing professionals with their studies. If that is something that you are interested in, consider subscribing. If you're already a subscriber though, thank you so much for your love and support. I see you. I upload my nursing educational videos at least once a week. Don't miss that out. Subscribe now. Hit the notification bell so that you will be the very first to watch my newest uploads. Also, don't forget to give this video a big thumbs up and share with your friends, because that will really help me know that you like to see more content like this. Without further ado, nurses, you guys ready? Let's do this. Hi, nurses! Kumusta kayo? Ano mga ganap nyo? Ngayon nga po ay tatalakay natin, or we're gonna have another discussion, another anatomy and physiology discussion video, because for today, we are going to discuss about your human blood. Yes! Kung hindi mo pa napapanood yung other nating discussion about sa anatomy and physiology, ililink ko yung actual playlist dyan. And gusto ko nga pala magpasalamat sa lahat ng mga bago nating subscriber, mga nursing students and nursing professionals nakaka-join lang sa channel ko, at sa mga datihena, maraming salamat po. Gusto ko lang magbigay ng shoutout sa bago ng member ng Team Kulto. Ito ay si Dr. Kenneth M. Rustico. Soon to be doctor po siya. Maraming salamat. At sa lahat ng mga bago nating kabaro nating nurses dyan, welcome sa ating Team Kulto. Yes, at kagaya nga na sinabi ko, marami nga pong itong aking channel nga po, inaalay ko sa lahat ng mga nursing professionals and nursing students para tulungan kayo sa pag-aaral nyo. Alam ko kasi napaka-broad ng concept ng nursing. I'll be putting all my nursing educational videos, playlists, sa description box, and kapag nagpop-out itong icon button dito, i-check out mo lang yun, i-click mo kasi nandun sila, okay? We're gonna have the description, the components of your blood, all of that good stuff, and more in one video. In order for me to do that, nurses, I will need to switch back to my PC, and I'll see you guys in a bit. Alright, hi nurses, welcome back sa ating formal discussion ng iyong blood anatomy and physiology. This is another entry natin sa ating anatomy and physiology playlist at nursing study guide. Ito nga po ay isa sa mga videos na ina-upload ko sa aking channel kung saan we are dealing with anatomy and physiology. Now, kung hindi mo pa napapanood yung iba nating NFV videos, make sure that you check out the description box, because I'll be putting it there. And also, kapag nagpop-out yung icon button, i-check mo lang yun, nandun lang sila, okay? Now, ano-ano ba yung mga dapat mong asahan sa ating discussion for today? Now, I'm gonna give you the objectives. First, we're gonna have, or we're gonna discuss the functions of the blood, the components of the blood, formed elements, hemostasis, and we're also going to talk about the blood groups and transfusion. Handa ka na ba? Let's begin. So, functions of the blood. Now, blood is unique. It is the only fluid tissue in the body. Begin natin ang description ito. Well, number one, carrier of gases, nutrients, and waste products. One of the functions of our blood. Now, oxygen enters blood in the lungs and is transported to the cells. Carbon dioxide produced by cells is transported in the blood to the lungs, from which it is expelled. Ingested nutrients, ions, and water are carried by the blood from the digestive tract to cells, and the waste products of the cells are moved to the kidneys for elimination. What are the other functions of the blood? Clot formation. Clotting proteins help stem blood loss when a blood vessel is injured. Transport of processed molecules. Most substances are produced in one part of the body and transported in the blood to another part. Protection against foreign substances. Antibodies help protect the body from pathogens. Transport of regulatory molecules. Various hormones and enzymes that regulate body processes are carried from the part of the body to another within the blood. Maintenance of body temperature. Warm blood is transported from the inside to the surface of the body, where heat is released from the blood. pH and osmosis regulation. Nurses, I know that you know that albumin is also the important, or is an important blood buffer and contributes to osmotic pressure of blood, which acts to keep water in the blood stream. Once again, nurses, these are the functions of your blood. All right, next na tayo.
components of blood, and sa mga susunod na slides, we're gonna talk about the physical characteristics and volume, including your plasma. Now, essentially, blood is a complex connective tissue in which living blood cells, the formed elements, are suspended. Eto na tayo, nurses. Now, physical characteristics and volume. Blood is a sticky, opaque fluid with characteristic metallic taste. In terms of color, depending on the amount of oxygen it is carrying, the color of blood varies from scarlet, yung tinatawag nating oxygen-rich. Pag nakakita ka ng scarlet-looking or colored blood, that is your oxygen-rich, to a dull red, which is oxygen-poor, or which indicates oxygen-poor. In terms of weight, blood is heavier than water and about 5 times thicker or more viscous, largely because of its formed elements. pH naman, blood is lightly alkaline with pH between 7.35 to 7.45. In terms of temperature, our blood is about 38 degrees Celsius or 100.4 degrees Fahrenheit. Now, this is always slightly higher than body temperature kasi isa nga sa mga function ng blood natin ay yung kinikip niya yung normal body temperature ng isang tao. So, yon. So, once again, this is the physical characteristics and volume of our blood. Now, when we talk about plasma, this is approximately 90% water. Plasma is the liquid part of the blood. Well, we're gonna talk about dissolved substances. Now, ano ba yung mga example nito? This could include nutrients, salts, electrolytes, respiratory gases, hormones, plasma proteins, and various wastes and products of cell metabolism. Ano pa? Plasma proteins. Now, when you say plasma proteins, these are the most abundant solutes in plasma. Except for antibodies and protein-based hormones, most plasma proteins are made by the liver. Composition. The composition of plasma varies continuously as cells remove or add substances to the blood. Assuming a healthy diet, however, the composition of plasma is kept relatively constant by various hemostatic mechanisms of the body. Once again, these are the descriptions of your plasma. Eto na tayo. Masyado ba mabilis? Kung masyado mabilis, pwede mo namang i-pause and then you kind of like go back to that slide kung saan medyo na mismo, okay? But humihinga ka pa ba? O, eto na tayo. Now, we're gonna talk about formed elements. Now, nurses, if you observed a stained smear of human blood under a light microscope, you will see disc-shaped red blood cells, so yung RBC, sorry. Now, a variety of gaudily stained spherical white blood cells and some scattered platelets that look like debris. Now, nurses, this is just an overview of your formed elements sa blood natin because I am actually planning to make a separate video discussing the blood elements in details, I mean to the T. But for this particular slide, for this particular video discussion, I am just gonna give you an overview. So, eto na. Unahin na natin ang iyong erythrocytes. Now, nurses, when you talk about your erythrocytes, may idea ba kayo? Of course. Now, erythrocytes, o mas kilala natin sa tawag na RBC, red blood cells, functions primarily to ferry oxygen in blood to all cells of the body. Erythrocytes, this is the part of the blood that carries your oxygen. Next, ano na? Siyempre, hindi mawawala. Kung may erythrocytes, meron kang leukocytes. Although leukocytes or white blood cells, WBC, are far less numerous than red blood cells, they are crucial to body defense against disease. Kasi nga sa leukocyte natin, dito yung mga tinatawag nating mga neutrophils, basophils, eosinophils, at sa susunod nating mga slides o sa gagawin kong slides, upcoming nating discussion, tatalakayin natin tong mga blood components na to, formed elements na to, in details. Alright? So may question ka ba sa leukocytes? Ilagay mo sa baba. Okay? Sasagutin natin yan. But now, let's proceed. Next blood components is your hematopoiesis. Now, blood cell formation or hematopoiesis occurs in red bone marrow or myeloid tissue. Now, when you say hematopoiesis, this is the production of all the cellular components of blood and blood plasma. It occurs within the hematopoietic system, which includes organs and tissues such as bone marrow, liver, and spleen. Now, simply, hematopoiesis is the process through which the body manufactures blood cells. Next, formation of red blood cells. Because they are anucleate, RBCs are unable to synthesize proteins, grow, or divide. Red blood cells are formed in the red bone marrow of bones. Stem cells in the red bone marrow are called hemocytoblasts. They give rise to all of the formed elements in blood. If a stem cell commits to becoming a cell called proerythroblast, it will develop into a new red blood cell. All right, next. Formation of white blood cells and platelets. Paano nga ba ito nabubuo, nurses? Okay, just an overview. Just like your erythrocyte production, the formation of leukocytes and platelets is stimulated by hormones. Red blood cells, most white blood cells, and platelets are produced in the bone marrow, the soft fatty tissue inside bone cavities. Two types of white blood cells are T and B cells, collectively known as lymphocytes, are also produced in the lymph nodes and spleen, and the T cells are produced and mature in the thymus gland. All right, now nurses, we're gonna talk about hemostasis. Ano nga ba to? Now, refresh lang natin. When you say hemostasis, the multi-step process of hemostasis begins when a blood vessel is damaged and connective tissue in the vessel wall is exposed to the blood. We're gonna talk about that more in a bit. Okay, medyo mahaba to ha. Kumuha ka na ng notes mo, chichiria, ipost mo muna tong video na to, humingahinga ka. Okay, vascular spasms occur. When you talk about this, the immediate response to blood vessel injury is vasoconstriction, which causes the blood vessel to go into spasm. The spasms narrow the blood vessel, decreasing blood loss until clotting can occur. Platelet plug forms. Injury to the lining of vessels exposes collagen fibers. Platelets adhere to the damaged site and platelet plug forms. Coagulation events occur. At the same time, the injured tissues are releasing tissue factor, yung ating TF, a substance that plays an important role in clotting. PF3, a phospholipid that coats the surface of the platelets, interacts with TF, vitamin K, and other blood clotting factors. This prothrombin activator converts prothrombin present in the plasma, the thrombin and enzyme. Thrombin then joins soluble fibrinogen protein into long hair-like molecules of insoluble fibrin, which forms the meshwork that traps RBCs and forms the basis of the clot. Within the hour, the clot begins to retract, squeezing serum from the mass and pulling the ruptured edges of the blood vessel closer together. Okay? So, next na tayo. Blood groups naman to and transfusion. Nurses, as we have seen, blood is vital for transporting substances through the body. When blood is lost, the blood vessels constrict and bone marrow steps up blood cell formation in an attempt to keep the circulation going. The compensatory mechanism to ng ating katawan. Okay. Now, human blood groups. Although whole blood transfusions can save lives, people have different blood groups and transfusing incompatible or mismatched blood can be fatal. Tandaan natin yon. So we have your antigen. An antigen is a substance that the body recognizes as foreign. It stimulates the immune system to release antibodies or use other means to mount a defense against it. Antibodies. One person's RBC proteins will be recognized as foreign if transfused into another person with different RBCs. The recognizers are antibodies present in the plasma that attach to RBCs bearing surface antigen different from those on the patient's blood recipient's RBCs. Agglutination. Binding of the antibodies causes the foreign RBCs to clump. A phenomenon called agglutination, which leads to the clogging of small blood vessels throughout the body. Next, you have your ABO blood groups. The ABO blood groups are based on which of two antigens, type A or type B, a person inherits. Absence of both antigens results in type O blood. Presence of both antigens leads to type A, B. The presence of either A or B antigen yields type A or B blood. Rh blood groups. The Rh blood groups are so named because one of the 8 Rh antigens, yung ating agglutinogen D, was originally identified in Rh use. Now, later, the same antigen was discovered in human beings. Side note lang, fun fact, most Americans are Rh positive. Now, what does it mean? Now, it only means that their RBCs carry the Rh antigen. Anti-Rh antibodies. Unlike the antibodies of the ABO system, anti-Rh antibodies are not automatically formed and present in the blood of Rh negative individuals. Lastly, you have your hemolysis or yung rupture of RBCs. Now, hemolysis does not occur with the first transfusion because it takes time for the body to react and start making antibodies. So once again, you guys, these are your blood groups, all right? Okay, malapit na talaga tayo matapos, ha? Ito na tayo sa ating blood typing. Now, blood typing of ABO blood groups, when serum containing anti-A or anti-B antibodies is added to a blood sample diluted with saline, agglutination will occur between the antibody and the corresponding antigen. Cross-matching. Cross-matching involves testing for agglutination of donor RBCs by the recipient serum and of the recipient's RBCs by the donor serum. Blood typing for Rh factors. Typing for the Rh factors is done in the same manner as ABO blood typing. Nurses, may naintindihan ba? Ayan na. And nandito na tayo sa end ng ating slide. Thank you so much again, nurses, for listening and watching this video. I hope you learned something. Please like and share, subscribe to my channel for more nursing educational videos. Let me know if you have other nursing topics that you want me to create for you. Put it down in the comment section below. Abangan nyo po yung mga next nating video regarding sa NFE natin. At kung hindi mo pa napapanood, I want to encourage you again to watch it, including the other playlist I created under the concept of your nursing education. Tulungan mo na nga ako, help spread out the news about my channel. Kasi alam mo naman, ito ang pinakamasaya, pinakabago, at pinakalibreng review, nursing review center sa balat ng YouTube. I'll see you again, nurses.
Thank you so much, nurses, for watching. I hope you learned something. Help me grow my channel. You are already here. You might as well subscribe. Hashtag Team Kulta. Don't forget to check out the other playlists I created for you. I'll be putting the links on the description box or simply click this icon button right here. Let's connect. Follow me on all my other social media accounts. Everything is at Neil Gavin. I'll see you again.